Hello, welcome back to the channel RBMCQ Bank Knowledge Booster. Today in this video, I'm going to discuss about MCQ on injuries to birth canal, that is degrees of perineal tear, uterine rupture, vulval hematoma, and much more. Okay, now let's start. Here is the first question. The question is that what are the risk factors for third degree perineal tear? Options are option A, big baby. That is, weight is more than 3 kg or equal to 3 kg. Option B, nulli periti. Option C, shoulder dystocia. Option D, all of the above. So here the correct option is option D, all of the above. Next question number 2. Injury to perineum involving perineal body, that is muscles, but not involving the anal sphincter is classified in which of the following degrees? Option C, option A, first degree. Option B, second degree. Option C, third degree. Option D, fourth degree. So here the correct option is option B, second degree. Okay, so let me make you clear one thing. In the first degree injury, it occurs to perineal skin only. In third degree, injury occurs to perineum involving the anal sphincter complex, both external and internal. And in 4th degree injury, it occurs to perineum involving the anal sphincter complex and anal epithelium. Here in the diagram, you can see the degrees of perineal tear, which is mentioned very clearly. Next question number 3. Collection of blood anywhere in the area between the pelvic peritoneum and the perineal skin is called. Options are option A, pelvic hematoma. Option B, vulval hematoma. Option C, infraliferator hematoma. Option D, supraliferator hematoma. So here the correct option is option A, pelvic hematoma. Next question number 4. Extension of cervical laceration or primary colporesis, that is vault rupture, lower uterine segment rupture are the causes of. Options are option A, supraliferator hematoma. Option B, infraliferator hematoma. Option C, pelvic hematoma. Option D, none of the above. So here the correct option is A, supraliferator hematoma. What are the causes of rupture of the uterus? Options are option A, spontaneous. Option B, scar. Option C, iatrogenic or traumatic. Option D, all of the above. So here the correct option is option D, all of the above. Next question number 6. Results from rupture of the lower segment scar or extension of a cervical tear into the lower segment with formation of a broad ligament hematoma is. Options are option A, complete rupture. Option B, incomplete rupture. Option C, obstructive rupture. Option D, non-obstructive rupture. So here the correct option is option B, incomplete rupture. Next question number 7. In what type of uterine rupture? The rupture involves the anterior lower segment transversely and often extend upwards along the lateral uterine wall. The margins are ragged and necrosed in. Options are option A, spontaneous non-obstructive rupture. Option B, obstructive rupture. Option C, complete rupture. Option D, none of the above. So here the correct option is option B, obstructive rupture. So spontaneous obstructive rupture here usually involves the upper uterine segment of the uterus and often involves the fundus. And in complete rupture, usually it occurs following disruption of the scar in the upper uterine segment. So this is the difference between spontaneous obstructive rupture and complete rupture. So here in the diagram, you can see the ragged and necrosed margin. Next question number 8. In what type of uterine rupture, the fetus is with or without the placenta usually escapes out of the uterus? Option C, option A, complete rupture. Option B, incomplete rupture. Option C, spontaneous non-obstructive rupture. Option D, scar rupture. So here the correct option is option A, complete rupture. Next question number 9. In what type of uterine rupture, maternal death rate is about 20% or more. Options are option A, obstructed labor. It may be spontaneous or instrumentation. Option B, scar rupture. Option C, iatrogenic or trauma. Option D, complete rupture. So here the correct option is option A, obstructed labor. It may be spontaneous or instrumentation. Next question number 10. What is the management of uterine rupture? Options are option A, resuscitation. Option B, laparotomy. Option C, subtotal hysterectomy. Option D, all of the above. So here the correct option is option D, all of the above. Next question number 11. Which of the following hematoma is the commonest one? Options are option A, pelvic hematoma. Option B, valval hematoma. Option C, supralevator hematoma. Option D, none of the above. So here the correct option is option B, valval hematoma. Next question number 12. What is the end result of an obstructed labor? Options are option A, spontaneous rupture. Option B, obstructed rupture. Option C, both A and B. Option D, none of the above. So here the correct option is option B, obstructed rupture. Next question number 13. What is the diagnostic features of a spontaneous rupture of the uterus? Options are option A, shock. Option B, absence of FHR. That means fetal heart rate. Option C, both A and B. Option D, none of the above. So here the correct option is option C, both A and B. Next question number 14. What type of uterine rupture is also called as silent rupture? Options are option A, scar rupture. Option B, traumatic rupture. Option C, spontaneous rupture. Option D, complete rupture. So here the correct option is option A, scar rupture.